It's the NFL on EA Sports. And coming up, we'll see the dynamic Alvin Kamara. He was outstanding last week, racking up a ton of yards and touchdowns. It's the Saints and the Ravens under the lights on Monday night.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. Tonight, it's the second of our Monday night doubleheader as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Raven team as they get ready here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week.
The Saints offense ready to get things started, coming off their first win of the season a week ago. And the one this defense will need to contain is this man, their second-year wideout. He's off and running here early in the season. Two good outings for him catching the football.
And that's a surprise to absolutely nobody, because defensively, you know you've got to try and limit his touches, keep the ball out of his hands. But right now, he's playing with some confidence, and I just know his offense coordinator is dialing up a few plays just for him.
Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay.
Delay of game. Offense.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. Right to the air is Carr. And incomplete to open things up. Yeah, look at this Baltimore defense. This unit against the pass, hoping to get better for sure. Number 25 in the NFL right now.
And the easy thought process is that stopping the run is the least of their problems, because they're facing the number one passing team in the NFL. But if they don't stop the run as well, then that just opens up the passing game even more. They've got to do both.
Another throw and second down, and this one incomplete as well.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
He lets it go deep for Olave. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A big-time play there for New Orleans. 45 yards. All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't. But it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, it makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup. The Saints at 1-1 through two games thus far. It's not a start that's going to set the world on fire, but they've been pretty solid nonetheless.
And the first thing that crosses my mind is certainly beats the alternative of starting 0-2. I do think that this is a team that's going to take a little time to find its footing. Hard to navigate the always tough NFL.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And that might have been a situation where even though you don't hit on the deep throw, you at least put in the defenders' minds early in the game that we're going to press the ball deep against your secondary. And that can have a ripple effect on how they function throughout.
Look in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
New Orleans Saints, they get ready to set up shop for their second drive. A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. We'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they have had a lot of time to cool off from reaching the end zone the last time. So have they been able to keep themselves mentally sharp and into this game, even though they haven't been on the field? And you and I both know, one big play, though, gets them right back up to that level.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Carr. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete. Here, look at this Baltimore defense. This unit against the pass, hoping to get better for sure. Number 25 in the NFL right now.
They spent the week at practice, Sam. We know our rating's not that great. And we know we're facing the number one passing team in the league. But there are some things that we can do to give ourselves a chance in this game.
On play action, now Carr. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Carr to throw again. He finds his man complete. That's Guzman. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He's trying to parlay that great performance last week, NFC Offensive Player of the Week in Week 2, into a great performance in Week 3.
And the way he was able to do it last week, he started off doing it again this week. Energy, the way he comes off the line of scrimmage, attacks the defense, sets them back on their heels, and he finds openings as a result.
On first down, Carr. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Almost feels like anything you can do, we're going to try and match or do better. We've already seen one touchdown pass from the opposition. They tried to equal it on that throw.
Now Carr. He finds his man complete. That's Guzman. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 31-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 down at the 31. Now Carr. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Against a team coming off a win, just as your team did the previous week, you talk about being physical all game long. Sometimes being physical is just being on the spot and helping force the incompletion.
That is pulled in by Michael Thomas. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Saints have moved out in front.
When you're a great route runner, it makes you that much better as a receiver because now your quarterback trusts that you're going to be where he expects and he's able to deliver the ball on time.
Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Carr will try it again on second down. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
And they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on the first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get that back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that,
down on the field comes New Orleans. First down. His throw incomplete.
Help me out here a little bit, partner, because because what I'm seeing is a passing game that's just struggled to complete anything. No rhythm, no timing. Seems like every pass is also contested well, so give some credit to the defense.
On second down, Kamara. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on second down, they hit him with the draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
Well, you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on second and long when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are on the field and they're only thinking one thing, get to the quarterback. Oftentimes you can bypass him with a running play.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
Throwing on first down is Carr. And his throw is incomplete. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Here's Kamara off the draw. He won't find a ton of space following the display of power as he's down just inside the 45. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Throwing his car on 3rd down. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one...
Attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge and opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a 2-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out. Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And this will be a jet sweep. Here's Thomas with it. Shoves him aside. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Play action. Now it's Carr. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. His 11th touchdown of the year. And the Saints have got it back to within a score. And that time, he came out of the slot for that big play downfield for the score.
I think what we just saw there, partner, was what we call scheming a guy open. Put him in the slot, know that he has tremendous speed. What you're doing with your other receivers is likely running shorter routes to draw the attention closer to the line of scrimmage to give him a chance to get downfield and turn it into a one-on-one route, often against the safety. You like your odds when he's running against the safety. His speed usually...
The New Orleans offense set to take over. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a 2-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. Now a play fake, Carr. He finds his man, complete. That's Guzman. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. It's a gain of 34.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Shotgun now for Carr. He finds his man complete. It's Guzman. Touchdown! A great play there. His second touchdown of the game, giving him 12 on the season. And the Saints have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And you sense the tide turning. They scored, then their defense forced the punt, and now a chance to ultimately take the lead here late. Carr now on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try to chip away at that. And thus far, they've been successful.
The Saints first down there on a gain of 11. First down. To throw, it's Carr. He lets it go, deep for Olave. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, New Orleans. Making four touchdown passes now for Derek Carr. And the Saints use the defensive breakdown to take the lead away here in the fourth. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through, all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Trying to run down some clock with Kamara. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Working from the gun, it's Carr. He finds his man, complete. That's Guzman. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
A gain of 21 yards. First down.
Of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. He'll get it to the 40. He broke a tackle there but couldn't get much further. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
That is certainly one way to put it in the quarterback. And it's extra defenders on the field. Dime package, lots of speed, no space to fit in.
Kamara, try the right side. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
You get in a second and long situation down here in the red zone, I'd say most defensive coaches would think pass, let's bring some pressure. So this is kind of a tendency breaker here to hit him with something on the ground, and he'll take it all the way into the end zone.
Score this many points, it's a complete blowout, but instead they needed every single one of those in this close, high-scoring affair.
And Brandon, I'm still on the edge of my seat after that one, because when you have that much scoring and it still comes down to one possession game at the end, that's not something we see very often. And in this case, these offenses, they brought it. The defenses,
can I talk my come on that other side, the Oakley way. C5. Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else because I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dreams so big might die in my sleep. And I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss. Remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly him to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. But don't get it twisted. Still clocking big digits. On Rodeo, big spending. All the crib's luxury. I can't recall the last time I did this. It's big business. All my deals, six figures and up. When you get it out the mud, it hit different. You should sell when the cops came, we hit fences. Now I'm blowing smoke out the country with two big. Take them both back to the penthouse and get. That's how it's supposed to be. Life is beautiful. I'm doing won't believe. Flew out to Colombia and brought me. Used to be the underdog. Now they put me overseas.
Anyone getting on the sticks tonight?
Yeah, I'm game, dude. Let's do it.